Good afternoon, ladies, gentlemen, brethren and guests. The first part of this evening's is the announcement for the emergency management procedures for the Wellington venue that we're in. So can you please take a moment to draw, I need to draw your attention to the procedures we should follow in this venue in the unlikely event of a fire or an earthquake. In the event of an emergency, please follow the instructions of the venue's Wellington Safety Wardens. They will be in high-vis vests for easy recognition. Exits are well marked, but please take a moment to familiarise yourself with the exit nearest to you. If we are required to evacuate the venue, then the assembly points for the Michael Fowler Centre are Jack Islet Green, north end of the building, and the lower Cuba Street, south end of the building. In the event of an earthquake, please follow the procedure of drop, cover and hold. Please do not evacuate unless instructed to do so by the venue safety wardens. If you require first aid or in the case of a medical emergency, please let one of the venue or catering team know and they will assist. The final housekeeping note is the bathrooms are located both upstairs and downstairs from the Auditorium Renoff Centre level, as well as off the Fletcher Challenge foyer. And finally, please turn your cell phones to flight mode if you can do so, otherwise turn them completely off, so we can't have any disruptions for this afternoon. And just a reminder for all the assembled Masons upstairs to remain seated during the proclamations, along with the other guests in the auditorium. Thank you. Standing to receive Right Worshipful Brother Pratt, Divisional Grand Master, representing the Host Central Division.
Brethren, be seated. Distinguished guests, ladies, gentlemen, Brethren all, I extend to you a warm welcome from the Central Division to this, the 80th Grand Installation of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand.
Thank you. Most worshipful Grand Master and officers of Grand Lodge are assembled and will enter immediately.
Brethren, you will be upstanding to receive the Grand Master, Most Worshipful Brother Graham Wrigley, and officers of Grand Lodge.
Brethren, I declare this Grand Lodge resumed.
Be seated, brethren. Most wishful Grand Master, the representatives of the Grand Lodge of Scotland are in attendance and seek admission.
Very worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, we'll be pleased to admit them.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I present Brother Ford, District Grand Master, North Island, and Brother Gilkinson, Right Worshipful District Grand Master, South Island.
Brother Gilkinson, welcome to this Grand Lodge. It's a pleasure to have you in our company, and I trust that you'll enjoy the afternoon.
Thank you very much, a pleasure to be here.
Right Worshipful Brother Tony, trust that you will enjoy as well. Absolutely. Thank you for your attendance.
Great pleasure to be here this afternoon.
Thank you.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, the representative of the Grand Lodge of Ireland is in attendance and seeks admission.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, will we please to receive the representative of the Grand Lodge of Ireland.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I present Right Worshipful Brother Suthic, Provisional Grand Master of the Provisional Grand Lodge of Ireland in New Zealand.
Right Worshipful Brother John, welcome into this Grand Lodge, and I trust that the afternoon will be one of profit and pleasure to you.
Most Worshipful, definitely looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Pleasure to be here.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, the Worshipful Brethren of the United Grand Lodge, representatives of the United Grand Lodge of England are in attendance and seek admission.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, will be pleased to receive the representative of the United Grand Lodge of England.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I present Right Worshipful Brother Weir, District Grand Master, District Grand Lodge, North Island, and Right Worshipful Brother Taylor, District Grand Master, District Grand Lodge, South Island.
Right Worshipful Brother Warren, welcome into this Grand Lodge, and I trust that the afternoon will be one of great pleasure to yourself. Thank you for attendance.
Thank you.
Right Worshipful Brother Richard, welcome, another South Islander, into our Grand Lodge here, and I trust you will enjoy the afternoon as well. Thank you both for your attendance.
Most Excellent Grand Master, on behalf of His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent, the United Grand Lodge of England, may I express our deep thanks and support for you and the support that you have given our lodges during the period of your leadership.
Thank you.
Thank you. Most Merciful Grand Master, the Most Excellent First Grand Principal of the Supreme Grand Royal Arts Chapter of New Zealand is in attendance and seeks admission.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, will be pleased to receive the Most Excellent First Grand Principal of the Supreme Royal Arts Chapter of New Zealand.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Most Excellent Companion Lane, First Grand Principal of the Supreme Grand Royal Arts Chapter of New Zealand.
Most Excellent, welcome into this Grand Lodge. A pleasure to receive you, as you have done into your various activities. I hope you enjoy the afternoon.
Thank you, Grand Master. It's a privilege to be here on this auspicious occasion.
Thank you.
Upstanding brethren, we will salute Most Excellent Companion Lane, First Grand Principal of the Supreme Grand Royal Arts Chapter of New Zealand, with the honours due to his high and exalted rank, seven times, taking the time from me. Be seated, brethren. Most Worshipful Grand Master, the Most Worshipful Grand Masters of the Grand Lodges of Hawaii and Oregon and the Grand Masters of Australia are in attendance and seek admission.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, we will be pleased to receive the Grand Masters of the Grand Lodges of Hawaii and Oregon and the Grand Masters of the Grand Lodges of Australia.
Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present to you Most Worshipful Brother Kanai, Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of Hawaii.
Grand Master, I welcome you into New Zealand and to this constitution for this grand installation, and I trust that you will enjoy something perhaps a bit different to what you may experience in your home country. But welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you very much, and thank you for the honor.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Most Worshipful Brother Posler, Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of Oregon.
Most Worshipful Brother Mark, welcome to this Grand Lodge. Having travelled quite some distance like your fellow Freemason from your great country, welcome here, and I trust you'll enjoy the afternoon.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to join you.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Most Worshipful Brother Harper, Australia Fire Service Medal, Grand Master of the United Grand Lodge of Queensland.
Most Worshipful Brother Jeff, welcome into this Grand Lodge from one firefighter to another, although we're both retired. But it's good to have you in our jurisdiction, and I trust that you and your delegation will enjoy the afternoon.
We certainly will, Most Worshipful Grand Master. Thank you.
Grand Master, I have the honour to present Most Worshipful Brother Gannon, Grand Master of Western Australia.
My friend, Most Worshipful Grand Master, welcome into our jurisdiction and thank you for joining us for this celebration.
Thank you, Most Worshipful Brother Graham. It's an absolute pleasure to be with you, and this time we will be able to get back home.
One hopes so. Thank you.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Most Worshipful Brother Odie, Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of Tasmania.
Most Worshipful Brother Philip, welcome to this Grand Lodge and thank you for joining us for this special occasion.
Thank you, Miss Ryan. It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Right Worshipful Brother Booker, Acting Grand Master for the United Grand Lodge of Victoria.
Right Worshipful Booker, welcome to our Grand Lodge and thank you for joining with us, and I trust again that you will enjoy the ceremony that is about to follow.
Thank you for your welcome, and I'm sure we will. Thank you very much.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Most Worshipful Brother Hicks, Grand Master of the United Grand Lodge of New South Wales and the Australian Capital Territory.
Most Worshipful Brother Les, welcome into New Zealand. I think you're probably our closest neighbour from Australia, across that ditch we often talk about. Welcome into this Grand Lodge, and I trust that you'll enjoy the afternoon's proceedings.
Thank you, Most Worshipful Grand Master.
Thank you.
Most Wishful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Most Wishful Brother Booker, Order of Distinguished Service, Grand Master of the South Australia and the Northern Territory.
Most Wishful Brother David Booker, welcome to this Grand Lodge. Pleasure to have you with us, and I trust that you will enjoy the afternoon.
Brethren, we will salute the most worshipful Grand Masters of the Grand Lodges of Hawaii and Oregon and Australia with the honours due to their exalted and supreme rank, the Grand or Royal Sign, 11 times, taking the time from me. Be seated, brethren.
I now invite Worshipful Brother Reverend Chris Douglas Hirawai to offer a karakia. Brethren, guests, ladies and gentlemen, would you please be upstanding?
Ara mai tonu rā e te kai hanga i runga i te upoko hau, i te pāmaranga, i te puehutanga mai o te aroha. Hei, ko koe tērā e te atua te pūtaketanga mai o te aroha, te pūtaketanga mai o ngā mea papai katoa. Nō reira tēnei mātou e tūna wā mātou whakamoimiti, whakawhetai ki a koe mo tēnei rā nā hau i hanga. Mo te hau e pupuhi ana, mo te ua e marangai ana, mo te rā e whiti ana, mō ngā hua papai katoa o tō wairua e te atua, anei rā tā mātou mihi whakawhetai. Nō reira e tiori nei ngā manu e whiti nei te rā, e ara nei te tangata e hihiko nei te wairua. Pauā ki roto kia mātou te whakaaro nui me te whakaaro pai, kia mura ai te ahi kā o tō wairua tapu. Nō reira hei moa koe ia mātou e te kaihanga, hei tōutou ia mātou mai katoa. Ko koe anō hoki hei whakakaha i a mātou, kia whai korore ai koe i a mātou mahi katoa. He mea tīmata, he mea mahi, he mea whakaoti i roto i a koe. Kia whiwhiai hoki mātou ki ngā mea e tika ana ki tā hau tītiro, kāti i tau, so mote it be.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, brethren, please remain standing for the reception of the New Zealand National Flag, which during we will sing the New Zealand National Anthem.
Oh,
Please be seated. Very Worshipful Brother Williams, Grand Secretary, you will now read the warrant of election of Grand Master.
The Grand Lodge of Ancient, Free and Accepted Masons of New Zealand, to all our Most Worshipful, Right Worshipful, Very Worshipful, Worshipful and Loving Brethren and Grand Lodge assembled, these are to certify that James Leslie Watt has been regularly elected Grand Master of the Freemasons of New Zealand for the ensuing 3 years and until a successor has been regularly elected in his stead. Given under my hand and the seal of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand at Wellington this 12th day of November, Anno Lucius 6022, Anno Domini 2022, Paul Chappell, President of the Board of General Purposes.
I now request four masters, a grand standard bearer, and four grand stewards to withdraw for the purpose of introducing the Grand Master elect.
Most Worshipful installing Grand Master. The Grand Master elect is in attendance and is in readiness to be installed into office when it is your pleasure to receive him.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, we shall receive him with much pleasure. Please admit him.
Upstanding brethren.
Let us pray. Almighty God, eternal source of life and light, we seek your grace and guidance for your servant, right worshipful brother James Leslie Watt, who is now to be installed as Grand Master of our fraternity. Endue him with wisdom and insight, counsel and strength, love and understanding. Enable him so to bear rule that he may keep in view the best interests of the great brotherhood committed to his charge. Uphold those who will work with him, that they may do so in peace, love, and harmony. May they ever be faithful and zealous, and assist to uphold the hand of their chief in all good deeds. Strengthen and support all who labor in the craft, that its ideals and values may be as leaven in our communities at all times. So
Most worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present for investiture, for installation, Right Worshipful Brother James Leslie Watt, who has been elected Grand Master for the ensuing 3 years.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, you will conduct the Grand Master elect to the pedestal and there take his obligation of office.
I, James Leslie Watt, in the presence of Almighty God and before the Grand Lodge of New Zealand, do promise and swear that to the best of my ability, I will faithfully, honestly, and impartially perform the duties of Grand Master in this jurisdiction during my term of office, and that I will conform to and maintain the Constitution, laws, rules, and regulations of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand, and the usages and customs of free and accepted Masons, and at all times enforce strict obedience thereto. So help me God.
seated, brethren.
Okay, gentlemen.
Is he going to address me?
No,
first?
No, no.
Most worshipful Grand Master, for from henceforth you are entitled to be thus hailed. The office of Grand Master is one of great antiquity and respect, and is the highest dignity to which a Freemason may aspire. By immemorial usages and irrevocable landmarks, he is invested with the powers and privileges which are well nigh absolute. To rule well, however, he should possess and practice several important requisites. As a man, he should be of approved integrity and irreproachable morals, free from the domination of hasty temper and ill-governed passions, be of good repute in the world, and practice as an example to the craft the cardinal virtues of fortitude, prudence, temperance, and justice. As a citizen, he should be loyal to our government, obedient to its laws, prompt in the duties that he owes to society, and be a pattern of fidelity in all social and domestic obligations. As a Freemason, he should cling to the old landmarks and be sternly opposed to their infringements. Be proficient in the laws, language, and literature of the fraternity. Be desirous to learn, but apt to teach. Though not for the time being a workman, yet be a master of the work and therefore qualified to earn his wages. Be prompt to aid and to relieve, but slow to demand. Be ever mindful that although elevated for the time being above his brethren, he has been elevated by them, that he is yet a craftsman, and so bound by a craftsman's obligation, and that he should cultivate everywhere and at all times the golden tenets of brotherly love, relief, and truth. As an officer, he should remember first of all that he is a Freemason, sharing in that respect a common lot with his brethren, and therefore interested in the welfare of each and all. Be devoid of undue ostentation and haughty overbearing. Be accessible to all, cultivating the closest friendship and the most unlimited confidence with his associated officers. Be eager to take counsel with his brethren and be ready to give it. Be patient in investigation and hearing. Be deliberate in judgment and prompt in execution. Be devoid of favoritism and wholly impartial. Be watchful over the treasury. Have an eagle eye upon every part of his jurisdiction and guard against the restless spirit of unwanted innovation. Therefore, the altered station to which the free choice of your brethren have now called you involves these great responsibilities and requires to be inaugurated by solemn sanction. It elevates you to a position from which the powers and prerogatives may depart at the expiration of your term of service, but the honour and dignity, except by your actions, never. I now clothe you with the insignia of your rank and authority. Oops, I knew that was coming. I invest you with this collar and jewels office. now symbolically invest you with this, but I call upon your son, entered apprentice, brother Chris Watt, to formally place it on you. In fact, you'll need both hands to do this, so I'll take that. Thanks very much. Well done. Surprise of the afternoon. Most worshipful Grand Master, I hand to you this gavel as a potent emblem of Masonic power, which in your hands should never be sounded in vain. I now surrender to you the seat of authority. And render to you this first act of homage due to you as Grand Master. I now hail, salute, and proclaim you Grand Master of Freemasons New Zealand. Brethren, behold your Grand Master. I now call upon the most worshipful brethren of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand on the dais to be upstanding and copy my example. Thank you. Remain standing. Brethren, we will sing the ode, Prosper the Man.
Upstanding, brethren. Seated, brethren.
Very worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, you will now make the proclamation.
Upstanding, brethren.
Mm-hmm.
for the first time and from the East, I proclaim Most Worshipful Brother James Leslie Watt, Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of Ancient, Free and Accepted Masons of New Zealand, for the ensuing 3 years and until a successor shall have been duly elected and installed in his stead. And I call upon you to salute him with the honours due to his exalted and supreme rank, the Grand or Royal Sign, 11 times, taking the time from me.
Brethren, we will sing the ode, Lord God, our Master bless. From the West, I proclaim Most Worshipful Brother James Leslie Watt, Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of Ancient, Free and Accepted Masons of New Zealand, for the ensuing 3 years and until a successor shall have been duly elected and installed in his stead. Brethren, we will sing the ode in wishes true and hearty.
Thank you.
the third time, and from the south, I proclaim Most Worshipful Brother James Leslie Watt, Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of Ancient, Free and Accepted Masons of New Zealand, for the ensuing 3 years and until a successor shall have been duly elected and installed in his stead.
Brethren, we will sing the ode, Great Architect, to thee we raise.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, whom do you appoint Deputy Grand Master?
I appoint Right Worshipful Brother Patrick Thomas Coonerty as Deputy Grand Master. Very Worshipful Brother Grand Director of Ceremonies, you will now present the Deputy Grand Master for investiture.
Brethren, you'll be upstanding to receive the Deputy Grand Master designate. Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present Right Worshipful Brother Patrick Thomas Cooney, who has been appointed to the office of Deputy Grand Master.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, you will conduct him to the pedestal to take his obligation of office.
Thomas Cooney, in the presence of Almighty God and before this Grand Lodge, do promise and swear that, to the best of my ability, I will faithfully, honestly, and impartially perform the duties of Deputy Grand Master in this jurisdiction during my term of office, and that I will conform to and maintain the Constitution, laws, rules, and regulations of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand, and the usages and customs of free and accepted Masons, and at all times enforce a strict obedience thereto. So help me God.
Straight back. Be seated, brethren.
Right Worshipful Brother, you would be aware that in the case of my inability to act in the contingencies mentioned in our Constitution, you succeed to my duties and prerogatives, as you also do in acting as my substitute in any matters specially delegated to you. Your office, therefore, is one of great dignity and importance, and it was in view of these considerations that you have been selected to fill it. Be mindful of the suggestions made to me as Grand Master, for you know not how soon they may have personal application to you. And remember also that usage, as well as our particular regulations, have placed you in a most intimate and confidential relation to me as a supporter and counsellor. Now, with pleasure, invest you with the collar and jewel of your office and proclaim you Deputy Grand Master of Freemasons of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand. I place you in your chair, which is at the right of the Grand Master.
All brethren below the rank of Deputy Grand Master will be upstanding.
Very Worshipful Brother Grand Director of Ceremonies, you will make the proclamation.
For the first time and from the West, I proclaim Right Worshipful Brother Patrick Thomas Cooney, appointed and duly invested Deputy Grand Master. And I call upon you to greet him, to salute him with the honours due to his exalted rank, the Grand or Royal sign, 9 times, taking the time from me. For the second time, and from the South, I proclaim Right Worshipful Brother Patrick Thomas Cooney, appointed and duly invested Deputy Grand Master. Brethren, be seated. Most Worshipful Grand Master, whom do you appoint President of the Board of General Purposes?
I appoint Right Worshipful Brother Chapel as President of the Board of General Purposes.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present for investiture the President of the Board of General Purposes.
Right Worshipful Brother Paul, it gives me great pleasure to invest you with the collar and jewel of your office, and I'm looking forward to working for the next 3 years with you. Thank Congratulations.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, whom do you appoint Divisional Grand Masters?
I appoint Very Worshipful Brother Lukasiewicz of the Northern Division, Very Worshipful Brother Turner, Central Division, and Very Worshipful Brother Pagan, Southern Division, as Divisional Grand Masters. Slight hiccup in the systems. Brethren, congratulations. I thank you each for taking on this role as Divisional Grand Masters of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand. Your roles are pivotal roles as we move forward as Grand Lodge, as we look at the number of views and things we have to face as we work together. I look forward to you being my eyes and ears in the divisions, and I look forward to the next 3 years of working with you. I'm now going to invite the outgoing divisional Grand Masters to invest their successes.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, whom do you appoint Grand Wardens?
I appoint Right Worshipful Brother Musgrove as Senior Grand Warden and Very Worshipful Brother Hunt as Junior Grand Warden.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, I have the honour to present for investiture the Senior Warden and the Junior Grand Warden.
Right Worshipful Brother Musgrove, I have much pleasure in investing you as Senior Grand Warden of the Grand Lodge, and I'm looking forward to 3 years of working with you. Congratulations. Very Worshipful Brother Hunt, now Right Worshipful Brother Hunt, I have much pleasure in investing you with the collar and jewel of your office as the Junior Grand Warden of the Grand Lodge of New Zealand. And again, I look forward to spending 3 years of working with you. Congratulations. Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, you will now continue with the investiture of officers.
Where's Dwayne?
Thank you.
a song or? Not yet. Are you having a song or? All brethren who have been invested will be upstanding.
Such is the nature of our constitution that as some must of necessity rule and teach, others of course must learn, submit and obey. Humility in each is an essential qualification. You who have been invested today as grand officers to assist our most worshipful the Grand Master in the well ruling and governing of our craft are too well acquainted with the rules of Freemasonry and the laws of our Grand Lodge to warrant any mistrust that you will be found wanting in the discharge of your duties or that you will exceed the powers entrusted to you. And all other brethren, I am sure, are of too generous a nature to envy you your preferment. I trust, therefore, that we will have but one aim in view, namely to please each other and to unite in the grand design of being happy and communicating happiness to others. For as this institution has been formed and perfected in so much unanimity and concord, so may it long continue. May you enjoy every satisfaction and delight which disinterested friendship can give within our respective lodges. May our children's children celebrate with joy and rejoicing the recurrence of our auspicious solemnities. May Freemasonry flourish in every part of the world and become influential in diffusing the light of knowledge, aiding the strength of reason, and in lessening the aggregate of human misery and vice. Firm in rectitude, may it rise superior to opposition, like the bleak mountain which bears its breast with dignified composure to the fury of the tempest and fearlessly presents its bosom to the midnight storm. As our order has been founded on the purest principles of piety and virtue, so may it teach us to measure our actions by the principles of morality and to guide our inclinations and, yes, even our very thoughts within the compass of propriety. Hence, we learn to be meek, humble, and resigned, to moderate the passions, the excess of which deforms the very soul, to be faithful to our God, our country, and our laws, to view with compassion the failings of a brother, and to pour the healing balm of consolation into the bosom of the afflicted. Brethren, such are the genuine principles and tenets of Freemasonry, and reflecting your enthusiasm, guidance and leadership, may they be transmitted through all our lodges and indeed throughout the whole fraternity, pure and unsullied from generation to generation.
Brethren, be seated.
Very Worshipful Grand Director of Ceremonies, you will conduct Most Worshipful Brother Wrigley to the floor of the lodge. Brother Wrigley, I have much pleasure in presenting to you, this collarette. It's a signal as your term of Grand Master.
Congratulations. Thank you for your 3 years in office.
Thank you, Most Worshipful Grand Master.
To our partners, our families, friends, distinguished guests, visiting grandmasters, brethren all, I extend my personal greetings and my thanks for your attendance today. In opening my remarks, I wish to acknowledge and pay tribute to the partners and our families, all of whom contribute so much to Freemasonry by the simple act of their support in us and our quest to be better men, better Freemasons, and to our making a difference in our communities. This is where I throw my notes out. I especially want to thank my partner, Penny, for her love and understanding, and for keeping secrets. To our sons, two of whom are on the stage today, and I only knew there was going to be one. I'll let you wonder out what the secret is. And there is a third son sitting in the balcony who flew out from America to join us today. Our wider family, my sister, our wider family, our friends, to all of you for the encouragement in my 38 years of being a Freemason. To the Grand Masters of Australia and the United States of America, and the delegations who have accompanied you, our sister constitutions, and to the members of the Royal Arch. Thank you for your attendance today at this celebration of New Zealand Freemasonry. Most Worshipful Brother Graham Wrigley, past Grand Master, I know this is not how you'd like your term of Grand Master to be remembered, that of being the Grand Master who steered us through a pandemic. But it was your clear, decisive decision-making and your prompt and clear communication that was the key to lodges and brethren being on board as we went through lockdowns, restricted numbers at meetings, and all the other inconveniences that COVID threw us. Most Worshipful Brother Graham, on behalf of the brethren and our wider Masonic family, I thank you for keeping our families and brethren safe during what must be the most disruptive period in New Zealand Freemasonry since World War II. You can look back on your term with pride at what you managed to achieve despite all the upheavals of COVID. I would like to also acknowledge your team of Grand Lodge officers who had an equally disrupted term in office. And I thank them for their commitment to their brethren and to the craft. My journey from being an entered apprentice to being Grand Master has been a journey of discovery and enlightenment, and I have been counselled and supported along the way by many brethren, too many to name. But I would like to single out one brother, Most Worshipful Brother Mike Pope, who has been a guide and mentor to me on this journey. Thank you, Most Worshipful, for your friendship and your wise and tactful counsel over the years. And I'd also like to acknowledge another brother who I was unaware was going to be here today, and that is Worshipful Brother Gordon Sutherland, who celebrated his 95th birthday yesterday and has been a great supporter of me during my Masonic travel. Brethren, it's a bit dry up here. There are two words you're not going to hear me mention over the next 3 years, and they are change and culture.
And there's a very good reason for that. We as Freemasons regularly roll them out when we discuss the ails that are affecting Freemasonry. Then we do nothing about them. But please be aware that both are topics which are high on my radar as we move forward. But what you will hear me regularly talk about, and passionately, are our younger Masons and the future. The future of the craft and how we, as one team of brethren, work together to do our bit to underpin the wonderful legacy which is Freemasonry. I've long thought that candidates join the craft for one reason, then stay for many others. I think our numbers prove that we are successful in encouraging candidates to join, but we're not so successful when it comes to encouraging them to stay. So, brethren, my message to you as Grand Master is, I want our organisation to give our younger members, aspiring and inquiring members, more of a voice. I want to see our newer brethren active in their lodge, participating in lodge activities, actively seeking and securing development opportunities, being invited to take on and accepting roles that enable them to contribute meaningfully to their lodge's growth and to its success, and ones that will help and support them as they grow in individuals with their vocations and within their communities. To this, I will be assembling early next year a brains trust or a think tank of younger Masons to give our younger members a voice in the future of the craft. It is time that we started investing in our younger members. And it is time for those of us who have already benefited from the teachings of Freemasonry, especially those of us who sit in the East, to take a step back and let our brethren, younger brethren lead, not follow. In 2019, we implemented a new 5-year strategic direction. And in the last 3 years, we have worked through this with the One Vision, One Goal, One Team implementation plan. This is due for renewal in February 2024. And I am proposing, rather than renew the document as a blue sky conceptual level, we enhance our existing plan by introducing annual project plans. These plans will be underpinned by a number of strategic imperatives and organisational priorities to ensure that a cohesive approach to managing the craft, but they will be operationally driven with clear and measurable outcomes that can be assessed each year. In a nutshell, they will keep our organisation focused on delivering the priorities and work streams that are important to us as we seek to grow and actively support our lodges and retain our brethren. Which brings me to November next year, 2023, where there will be a special grand communication, where we will introduce a remit amending the Book of Constitution to allow for an annual grand communication instead of the present 3-yearly cycle. I'm not talking about the annual grand an annual grand installation, that will stay triennial, but an annual business session akin to an AGM. A forum for members to gather to discuss the business and direction of the organisation and to debate and vote on the important issues that drive it. I'm suggesting that these events be held annually to enable us to pivot more quickly, to better adjust to and meet the differing challenges that may impact us. And we will do so using technology so that every lodge will be able to be represented and have a vote. And lastly, but by no means least, my next comments are about two important reviews we will undertake in our governance and organisational structure. Firstly, planning is already underway for an all of governance review, and brethren can expect to discuss and ratify the findings and recommendations of this at our special grand communication next year. We are talking about the size and the structure of our Board of General Purposes and our Grand Lodge trustees, and better defining their respective roles. As you might imagine, there are many and varied reasons for this governance review, and it will be fundamental to our future direction of travel as an organisation. Our second major review will focus on our present Masonic structure, which was established back in 2000 when we had a much larger membership. So it is timely that we reassess the continued roadworthiness of that. We will share these findings of this review with the brethren at the 2024 Grand Communication. And brethren, I'm on a mission. A mission by June 2025 to report on our joint charitable impact. As you all know, there are many Masonic charities, all working for a lesser or greater degree autonomously. Just think how great it would be if we issued an annual joint charitable impact report, detailing how Freemasons are making a difference in New Zealand. This is not saying that we're going to take control of these entities, far be it from it. But joining together as one team to report on the combined impact that we as Freemasons make in our wider communities. So, brethren, there is plenty on the plan. There's plenty on the agenda, and it's all focused on our future. An exciting future in which we achieve our organisational goals as Freemasons New Zealand. Our goals for the success and growth of individual lodges, and the personal goals as committed and hard-working brethren who want the best for ourselves, for our families, for our communities, and for the craft. Today is not just about the installation of a new Grand Master. It is also about the investing and the celebration of a new team of Grand Lodge officers who will lead and steer the craft over the next 3 years. To you all, I offer my congratulations. I'd like to think that in the next 3 years will see us all working together as one team to make a difference. Brethren all, I hope you will join me on that journey.
Most worshipful Grand Master, it's my great pleasure and honour to have the first opportunity for greetings on behalf of all the Australian Grand Masters and all our members in our individual constitutions. As your closest neighbour across the bridge, we've always had a very close and personal connection with a shared past history of mutual respect and support. We offer our congratulations and very best wishes to both yourself and all your newly appointed Grand Lodge officers invested here today. We are sure that was your very newly appointed team, and the soundly based foundation you've received from your predecessors, that you'll continue to grow Freemasonry in this wonderful country. We also offer congratulations to all who have participated in the wonderful ceremony today to assure its success, particularly Most Worshipful Brother Graham Wrigley, his Grand Director of Ceremonies and Assisting Officers. Most Worshipful Grand Master, we look forward to your continued friendship, support and leadership over your term of office. On a personal note, we wish you, Penny, the very best of health for your term of tenure of office, and encourage you to enjoy the journey in this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Most Excellent Grand Master, on behalf of His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent, Grand Master of the United Grand Lodge of England, the districts of the North Island and the South Island, may I extend to you our congratulations and best wishes to you and your officers. May that unique square of Freemasonry as practiced in New Zealand, made up of the four corners of the four constitutions, continue to work together in fellowship, friendship, and mutual support in the propagation of our genuine love of those ageless principles of Freemasonry, and to do all that is good and possible for New Zealand society.
Most Worshipful Master, on behalf of the Provincial Grand Lodge of Ireland and of the Provincial Grand Lodge of New Zealand, Grand Lodge of Ireland, I send you warm fraternal greetings and congratulations on achieving this, or the highest rank that you can achieve in the Grand Lodge of New Zealand. I would also like to send congratulations on behalf of the Grand Master, Most Excellent Grand Master Douglas T. Gray. I would also like to extend an invitation to you, your divisional and district grandmasters, to attend our lodges whenever time and circumstances prevail. Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Most Worshipful Brother Watt, Grand Master, I bring you greetings from the Grand Master of the Grand Lodge of Scotland. He's already written to you, giving you his congratulations, so I won't dwell further on it, but I'll just give greetings from the Grand Lodge of Scotland and wish you very well for your term of office, and I do hope that we will have the opportunity of seeing each other at the various meetings which we attend. I'm certainly looking forward to it.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, today is a very special day for Freemasonry in New Zealand, and I join with all brethren in congratulating and welcome you as our leader for the ensuing 3 years. Royal Arch Freemasonry is also an integral part of our fraternity, and as First Grand Principal, it is my privilege, on behalf of the brethren who are also Royal Arch Companions, to add the congratulations of the Supreme Grand Royal Arch Chapter of New Zealand, together with our best wishes for an enjoyable and successful term of office. The collegial relationship between the craft and Royal Arch in New Zealand is very strong. And in that regard, I must acknowledge with thanks the close cooperation and mutual concord we have enjoyed liaising with Most Worshipful Brother Graham Wrigley during his tenure. I know that the continuation and development of our craft and Royal Arch relationship is a key component of your own agenda, Grand Master, and we look forward to working with you to consolidate and future-proof Freemasonry in New Zealand. In all your endeavours, Most Worshipful, you may be assured that you will have the full support of Royal Arch Companions. Grand Master, we wish you well.
To the Most Worshipful Grand Masters of Australia and your brethren who have joined us from across the ditch, we again welcome you with that Anzac bond of friendship which binds us all together. And now that we're returning to some form of normality, we look forward to joining you with your grand installations over the ensuing 3 years. I'd like to especially welcome the Most Worshipful Grand Masters of Oregon and Hawaii and those brethren who have accompanied you. And it's indeed a pleasure to welcome you to New Zealand, or as we Kiwis refer to it, God's Own. Your presence here today, having travelled halfway around the world, has greatly enhanced the occasion. To our sister constitutions, the Grand Lodges of England, Ireland and Scotland, and to the members of the Royal Arch, I give you my personal commitment of working together with you all for the betterment of Freemasonry in New Zealand. I know that there's been a lot of work done over recent years with Most Worshipful Brother Wrigley, and I look forward to continuing that. To the members of the New Zealand Opera Chorus, to the Wellington Brass Band Ensemble, to our own grand organist, on behalf of all gathered here today, we thank you for your music and the joy that it has given us. And finally, to our partners, our families, our friends, and our guests, thank you for your attendance today. And to quote the proverb, it is the feathers that allow the bird to fly. You are those feathers. Brethren, assist me to close this Grand Lodge. All stand. Right Worshipful Junior Grand Warden, what is the constant care of every mate?
To prove the Grand Lodge close-tiled, Most Worshipful Grand Master.
You will direct that duty to be done.
Worshipful Grand Inagard, you will prove the Grand Lodge close-tiled.
The Grand Lodge.
Most Worshipful Grand Master, the Grand Lodge is close-tiled.
Right Worshipful Senior Grand Warden, your constant place in the Lodge.
In the West, Most Worshipful Grand Master.
Why are you so placed?
To close the Grand Lodge by the Most Worshipful Grand Master's command.
And may the blessing of the great architect of the universe be with us all, now and always.
Well, Senior Grand Warden, you have my command to close this lodge, this Grand Lodge.
Brethren, in the name of the great architect of the universe, and by command of the most worshipful Grand Master, I close this Grand Lodge.
And it is closed accordingly, until such time as most worshipful Grand Master may appoint.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, would you please join in standing in the singing of the Royal Anthem?
Guests, ladies, gentlemen, and brethren, you'll remain upstanding while the most worshipful Grand Master, the most worshipful, right worshipful, and other brethren on the dais retire, during which we will sing the recessional ode, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah.
Thank you.
Secretaries and brethren, you remain upstanding whilst Right Worshipful Brother Pratt, past Divisional Grand Master, the Senior and Junior Grand Wardens, and other elected officers retire. Ladies and brethren, thank you for your attendance. You may now retire.